Good morning to all. Today we are discuss another one gate topic, PN junction diode and rectifier from analog circuit under the scheme of AICTE 3 RENA. Myself N. Jyothipriya, Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Erode Sengundar Engineering College, Perundurai, Tamil Nadu. Now let us see that today's topic, PN junction diode. PN junction diode means one P-type semiconductor and one N-type semiconductor is suitably joined. Before enter the topic, first we know about what is P-type semiconductor and what is N-type semiconductor to understand the working of PN junction diode. Now let us see the P-type semiconductor. P-type semiconductor means trivalent impurities is added to pure semiconductor. Some of the trivalent impurities are gallium, aluminium, indium, boron. These trivalent impurities has three valence electron in their outermost orbit. These three valence electron forms three covalent band by neighboring atom. One covalent band is incompleted. The incompleted covalent band constitute holes. So in p-type semiconductor, number of holes is higher than the number of electrons, because in p-type semiconductor majority charge carriers is holes. Now p-type semiconductor is ready to accept one electron for completing their covalent band, so it is also called as acceptor atom. After accepting one electron from neighboring atom, it becomes negatively charged immobile ion. The negatively charged immobile ion does not participate the conduction. Now let us see the N-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor means pentavalent impurities is added to pure semiconductor. Some of the pentavalent impurities are phosphorus, antimony, arsenic, bismuth. These pentavalent impurities has five valence electron in their outermost orbit. From this five valence electron, four valence electron formed four covalent band by neighboring atom. One electron is excess. So in N-type semiconductor, number of electron is higher than the holes, because in N-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers is electrons. Now N-type semiconductor is ready to donate one electron for completing their covalent band. So it is also called as donor atom. After donate one electron, it becomes positively charged immobile ion. The positively charged immobile ion present in the N-type semiconductor does not participate the conduction. Now let us move our topic, PN junction diode. PN junction diode has one P-type semiconductor and one N-type semiconductor. In P-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers holes, minority charge carriers electrons. In N-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers electrons, minority charge carrier holes. The P-type and N-type semiconductor is suitably joined to form PN junction diode. PN junction diode is a two-terminal device. One terminal is anode, another one terminal is cathode. The anode terminal is taken from P-type and cathode terminal is taken from N-type. Figure shows the symbol of PN junction diode. In figure, the arrowhead indicates the current flow direction. In PN junction diode, current flows from anode to cathode in only one direction. So it is also called as unidirectional device. Now let us see the working of PN junction diode. PN junction diode working based on two category. One is unbiased condition and another one is biased condition. Unbiased condition means there is no external potential is applied to PN junction. Biased condition means the external potential is applied to PN junction diode. Now let us see unbiased condition operation of PN junction diode. unbiased condition means no external potential is applied to p-n junction diode. Here one p-type and n-type semiconductor is suitably joined. As soon as p-n junction diode is formed, as per the attraction and repulsion principle, electron moves from n side to p side. This electron is majority charge carriers of n side. Similarly, holes moves towards from p side to n side. This holes is majority charge carriers of p side. Now, electron hole pair recombination takes place. Here, hole is not a single particle. Holes consist of proton, electron, and neutron particle. So, weight or mass of the hole is higher than the electron. So, it moves slowly. But electron is a single particle. The mass of the electron is very low compared to hole. So, it moves positively. After recombination takes place, negatively charged immobile ion stored p side and positively charged immobile ion stored n side near the junction. These immobile ions arrange in a row manner. This immobile ions forms a layer. This layer is called as depletion layer. The depletion layer consists of immobile positive ion in n side and immobile negative ion in p side. This depletion layer constitutes a potential that is called as barrier potential. This barrier potential level is 0.7 voltage. We are using silicon material. We are using germanium material for manufacturing p-n junction diode. The barrier potential level is 0.3 voltage. The barrier potential is also known as knee voltage or barrier voltage. Now let us see the biased condition operation of p-n junction diode. The p-n junction biased condition operation can be classified into two ways. One is forward biased condition and another one is reverse biased condition. Now let us see the forward biased condition working of p-n junction diode. Forward bias means positive terminal of the battery is connected to the p side and negative terminal of the battery is connected to the n side. Majority charge carriers in P side is holes that repels the positive terminal of the battery. Similarly, majority charge carriers in N side is electron that also repels the negative terminal of the battery. So, holes moves towards the junction whereas electron in P side moves towards the junction. But applied voltage applied the internal barrier potential level. Further, we are increasing applied voltage. The junction is breakdown after the barrier potential voltage. Electron and hole pair recombine with each other. This constitutes a current. So, in p-type semiconductor, current conduction depends upon the both type of charge carriers, holes and electrons, so it is also called as bipolar device. Now let us see the reverse bias condition working of p-n junction diode. When n region of p-n junction is connected to positive terminal of the battery and p region of p-n junction diode is connected to negative terminal of the battery, then the p-n junction diode is said to be in reverse bias condition. Under reverse bias condition, majority charge carriers present in the holes attract the negative terminal of the battery. Similarly, majority charge carriers electron present in the n-type attract the positive terminal of the battery. So, depletion layer width increases. Further, we are increasing applied reverse potential. total majority charge carriers in P side and N side attracted by battery. Now in PN junction diode, only minority charge carriers is present. Further, we are increasing applied potential. The minority charge carriers require heavy energy due to the applied reverse bias voltage. This heavy energy minority charge carriers strike the junction and break the junction. That voltage is known as breakdown voltage. After breakdown occurs, enormous current flows through the device. This damages the device. Now let us see the VI characteristics of PN junction diode. VI characteristics of PN junction diode can be classified into two types. One is forward VI characteristics and another one is reverse VI characteristics. The VI characteristics of PN junction diode relates the voltage and current of PN junction diode. Now let us see the forward VI characteristics of PN junction diode. Forward VI characteristics of PN junction diode relates the forward voltage and forward current. Forward voltage is taking in x-axis and forward current is taking in y-axis. Forward bias means positive terminal of the battery is applied to the p-type semiconductor and negative terminal of the battery is applied to n-type semiconductor. We are increasing forward voltage before barrier voltage or knee voltage. Only voltage is increased, current value is zero. Once the barrier potential is reached, current flows through the device. That means after the barrier potential, in forward condition, voltage and current increases gradually. We are using silicon semiconductor. The barrier potential level is 0.7 voltage. So applied voltage increases the 0.7 voltage in silicon semi PN junction diode. The current flows through the device. We are using germanium semiconductor. The knee voltage level is 0.3. So after 0.3 voltage, current flows through the device. Now let us see the reverse VI characteristics of PN junction diode. Reverse VI characteristics of PN junction diode relates the reverse voltage and reverse current. The reverse voltage is taking x-axis and reverse current is taking y-axis. But the graph is drawn in fourth quadrant. First, we are increasing applied reverse voltage. Depletion layer width increases. There is no current flows through the device in theory, but in practical, due to minority charge carriers, small current is flows through the device. That current is called as reverse saturation current. The reverse saturation current depends upon the minority charge carriers. Further, we are increasing reverse voltage at one particular voltage level. The junction is breakdown. That voltage is called as breakdown voltage. After breakdown occurs, heavy current is flows through the device. Now the device will be in damaged condition. So PN junction diode is used in forward direction only. Now let us see the another topic, rectifier. Rectifier is one of the application of PN junction diode. Rectifier means it is a device that converts AC input signal into DC output signal. The rectifier output is not a pure DC, it is a pulsating DC. Rectifier output contains some ripple contents. The ripple is eliminated by using filter. A rectifier can be classified into two types. One is half wave rectifier, another one is full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier further classified into two types: center tapped full wave rectifier, bridge full wave rectifier. Now let us see the half wave rectifier. half wave rectifier convert only one half cycle of the applied AC input signal. Half wave rectifier consists one transformer, one diode and load. Load may be resistive nature, inductive nature or capacitive nature or combination of resistive, inductive, capacitive nature. In the diagram, we are using resistive nature load. The AC input signal is applied to primary of the transformer. The secondary of the transformer is connected to rectifier circuit. Rectifier circuit consists on diode and load. The secondary terminal, upper terminal is denoted A, lower terminal is denoted B. So, during positive half cycle of the applied AC input signal, the secondary terminal A is positive with respect to B. Now, anode terminal of diode is connected to positive and cathode terminal of diode is connected to negative. Now, the PN junction diode is in forward bias condition. Under forward bias condition, the diode acts as closed switch. So, current flows through the device or load. So, output voltage appears across the load. During the negative half cycle of the applied AC input signal, secondary transformer terminal A is negative with respect to B. Now, anode of the PN junction diode is connected to negative terminal and cathode is connected to positive terminal. Under this condition, PN junction diode is in reverse bias condition. Under reverse bias condition, the diode acts as open switch. So there is no current flows through the load. There is no output available across the load resistor. Figure shows the input and output waveform of half-wave rectifier. The first figure shows the applied input AC signal. The second figure shows the output of half-wave rectifier. Half-wave rectifier conducts only one half cycle during positive half cycle. So in this figure, the output is available only the limit 0 to pi and 2 pi to 3 pi. Now let us see the analyze of half-wave rectifier. Performance analysis of half-wave rectifier. Half-wave rectifier connect only one half cycle, so current flows through only one half cycle. So IL equal to Im sin omega t for 0 to pi, IL equal to 0 for pi to 2 pi. Here Im is peak value of load current. Now let us see the first performance factor, DC value or average value. It is denoted IDC. IDC equal to area divided by base. It is defined as area under the curve over a full wave to base. So IDC equal to 1 divided by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi IL d omega t. Full wave, full wave means 2 half cycle, so 0 to 2 pi. So base value is 1 divided by 2 pi. Now IL equal to Im sin omega t. Now substituting IL value, we get IDC equal to 1 divided by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi Im sin omega t into d of omega t. Now separating the limit for both of cycle, we get integral 0 to pi Im sin omega t into d of omega t plus integral the limit pi to 2 pi Im sin omega t into d of omega t, the whole term multiplied into 1 by 2 pi. The value of IL from pi to 2 pi is 0. So substituting this value, we get IDC equal to 1 divided by 2 pi into integral 0 to pi Im sin omega t into d of omega t plus 0. Now IDC equal to 1 divided by 2 pi integral 0 to pi Im sin omega t into d omega t. Im is a constant term. Taking outside the integral, we get Im divided by 2 pi into sin omega t t of omega t. Now, integrating sin omega t, we get Im divided by 2 pi minus cos omega t, the limit 0 to pi. Integrating of sin omega t equal to minus cos omega t. Now, substituting upper and lower limit, we get minus Im divided by 2 pi into cos pi minus cos 0. The value of cos pi equal to minus 1. The value of cos 0 equal to 1. Substituting this value, we get minus Im by 2 pi into minus 1 minus 1. So, IDC equal to 2 Im divided by 2 pi. Cancelling 2 to, we get IDC equal to Im by pi. Similarly, VDC equal to Vm by pi. Now, let us move to another performance factor, RMS value of half-wave rectifier. RMS value means root mean square value. The root mean square value is defined as the ratio of square root of area under the squared rectifier wave over a cycle divided by base. That is, IRMS equal to square root of 1 divided by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi IL square into d of omega t. Now, substituting IL value, we get IRMS equal to square root of 1 divided by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi Im sin omega t the whole square into d of omega t. Now, separating the limit for fourth off cycle, we get IRMS equal to square root of 1 divided by 2 pi integral 0 to pi Im sin of omega t the whole square into d of omega t plus integral the limit pi to 2 pi Im sin omega t the whole square into d of omega t. The value of pi to 2 pi, the current value is 0 because half-wave rectifier conduct only one half cycle. So, we get IRMS equal to square root of 1 divided by 2 pi into integral 0 to pi Im sin omega t the whole square into d of omega t plus 0. Im is a constant. So, taking outside the integral, we get square root of Im square divided by 2 pi integral 0 to pi sin square omega t into d of omega t. Now, substituting sin square omega t equal to 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2, we get IRMS equal to square root of Im square divided by 2 pi integral 0 to pi 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2 into d omega t. 2 is a constant. Taking outside the integral, we get square root of Im square divided by 4 pi into omega t minus cos 2 omega t into d of omega t. Now, integrating cos omega t minus cos 2 omega t, we get IRMS equal to square root of Im square divided by 4 pi into omega t minus sin 2 omega t divided by 2. Integrating cos 2 omega t, we get sin 2 omega t divided by 2. The limit is 0 to pi. Now, substituting upper and lower limit, we get square root of Im square divided by 4 pi into pi minus 0 minus of 0 minus 0. So, we get square root of Im square into pi divided by 4 pi. Cancelling pi value, we get IRMS equal to square root of Im square divided by 4. Removing the square, we get IRMS equal to Im by pi. Similarly, VRMS equal to Vm by pi. This is the RMS value of half-wave rectifier. Now, let us see the another performance factor, ripple factor. The unwanted AC component present in the DC output is called as ripple. The ripple can be eliminated by using filter circuit. The ripple factor is defined as the ratio of effective value or RMS value of the AC component of voltage or current to average value of voltage or current. The effective value or RMS value of current is given by I RMS equal to square root of I DC square plus I1 square plus I2 square, etc. The I1 square plus I2 square, etc. is equal to I AC square. So I RMS equal to square root of I DC square plus I AC square. We need RMS value of AC component. So I AC square equal to square root of I DC square plus I RMS square. Ripple factor gamma equal to I RMS divided by I DC. That's equal to I AC divided by I DC. So that's equal to square root of I RMS square minus I DC square divided by I DC. Simplifying this, we get I RMS divided by I DC the whole square minus 1. I RMS value is Im by 2. I DC value is Im by 5. Substituting I RMS and I DC in ripple factor, we get gamma equal to square root of Im divided by 2 all divided by Im by pi the whole square minus 1. Simplifying this, we get square root of 5 divided by 2 the whole square minus 1. Again, simplifying this, we get gamma equal to 1.21. In percentage, it is 121%. This is a very high ripple value. So half-wave rectifier is not used for practical application. It is only used for laboratory purpose. Now let us see the another one performance parameter of half-wave rectifier is efficiency. Efficiency is defined as ratio of DC output power to AC input power. Efficiency is denoted eta. DC output power is denoted PDC, AC output power is denoted PAC, so eta equal to PDC divided by PAC. PDC equal to DC output power, that is equal to IDC squared into RL. PAC equal to input supply, applied input signal, so PAC equal to I squared RMS into RL plus RF plus RS. Here RL is load resistance, RF is diode forward resistance, RS is transformer secondary resistance. IDC equal to Im divided by pi, IRMS equal to Im divided by 2. Substituting IDC and IRMS value in efficiency equation, we get Im by pi the whole square into RL divided by Im by 2 the whole square into RS plus RF plus RL. Now simplifying this equation, we get 4 divided by pi square into RL divided by RS plus RL plus RL. Compared to RL value, RS RF is very very low. So neglecting this, we get efficiency equal to 4 divided by pi square into RL by RL. Cancelling the term RL, we get efficiency equal to that is eta equal to 4 divided by pi square. Simplifying this in numerical value, we get eta equal to 0.406. Percentage of efficiency equal to 40.6%. So maximum efficiency of the half wave rectifier is 40.6%. The peak inverse value of half wave rectifier is Vm. The peak inverse value is defined as the maximum reverse voltage of the diode can withstand without destroying the junction. In half wave rectifier, it conducts only one half cycle. So peak inverse voltage of half wave rectifier is Vm. Now let us see the another performance parameter, transformer utilization factor. Transformer utilization factor is simply denoted TUF. TUF means how much amount of transformer utilized in the circuit is known as TUF. TUF is defined as the ratio of DC power delivered to the load to AC power rating of the transformer. DC power delivered to the load in half wave circuit is equal to PDC. PDC equal to IDC squared into RL. But AC rating of the transformer secondary equal to PAC rated. PAC rated equal to VAC rated into IAC rated. Output voltage, secondary transformer voltage is purely sinusoidal. The maximum value of secondary voltage is Vm. So it is purely sinusoidal. So VAC rated is equal to Vm into 1 by root 2. That is equal to Vm by root 2. But current is off sinusoidal because the diode conduct only one up cycle. So IAC rated equal to Im into 1 by 2. That's equal to Im by 2. So PAC rated equal to Vm by root 2 into Im by 2. Substituting PDC and PAC rated value in TUF, we get TUF equal to Im by pi the whole squared into RL divided by Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. Simplifying this equation, we get TUF equal to 2 root 2 divided by pi squared. Converting this into numerical value, we get TUF equal to 0.287. Percentage of TUF equal to 28.7%. So in this circuit, in the half wave rectifier, we are using 28.7% of transformer. Now let us see the next rectifier, full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier convert both the half cycle of applied AC input signal. Full wave rectifier can be classified into two types. One is standard tapped full wave rectifier and another one is bridge full wave rectifier. Now let us see the standard tapped full wave rectifier. The standard tapped full wave rectifier consists of one standard tapped transformer and two diode and load. The standard tapped full wave rectifier eliminates the disadvantage of the half wave rectifier. The half wave rectifier conducts only one half cycle, so core is saturated. This is eliminated by using standard tapped full wave rectifier. Here, full wave rectifier conduct both the half cycle, so no core saturation occurs. The standard tapped full wave rectifier consists of standard tapped transformer, two diodes, and load. The AC input signal is applied to primary of the transformer. In standard tap transformer, the upper terminal is denoted A, the lower terminal is denoted B, the center terminal is denoted O. So, during positive off cycle of the applied AC input signal, the secondary of the standard tap transformer A is positive, B is negative with respect to O. Under this condition, the diode D1 is forward bias and diode D2 is reverse bias. Because anode of the diode D1 is connected to positive terminal, cathode of the diode D1 is connected to negative terminal. But in diode D2, anode is connected to negative terminal, cathode is connected to positive terminal. So diode D1 is forward bias and D2 is reverse bias. So diode D1 acts as a closed switch, diode D2 act as open circuit. So current flows through the device upper part of the center tap transformer. So current flows from secondary transformer terminal A, diode D1, load, secondary transformer terminal O. So current flows through the load, output is appear across the load. During the negative off cycle of the applied AC input signal, the secondary of the standard tap transformer A is negative, B is positive with respect to O. Now diode D1 is reverse bias and diode D2 is forward bias. So forward biased diode D2 conduct current flows through the load from lower portion of the secondary transformer diode D2 load. So output voltage appear across the load. So in full wave rectifier, both the half cycle, we are getting the output. Figure shows the input-output waveform of full wave rectifier. The first figure shows the applied AC input signal. Second figure shows the output of full wave rectifier. During the positive half cycle, diode D1 is forward bias. It is in on position. Diode D2 is reverse bias. It is in off position. The diode D1 act as a closed switch. D2 act as a open switch. So output voltage appear across the load. Similarly, during negative up cycle, diode D2 is in forward bias condition, so it is in on position. It is act as a closed switch. But D1 is reverse bias condition. It is act as a open switch, so it is in off position. So output voltage appear across the load. But the output voltage value is half of the secondary voltage. For an example, the secondary voltage equal to Vm, the output voltage is Vm by 2. Now let us see the performance analysis of full wave rectifier. The full wave rectifier first parameter is average value or DC value of load current. That is denoted IDC. IDC equal to area under the curve over half cycle to base. It is defined as the ratio of area under the curve over a half cycle to base. Therefore, IDC equal to 1 divided by pi into integral 0 to pi IL d omega t. Now, substituting IL value, we get IDC equal to 1 divided by pi integral 0 to pi Im sin omega t into d of omega t. Im is constant, so taking outside the integral, we get Im by pi integral 0 to pi sin omega t into d of omega t. Now, integrating sin omega t, we get Im divided by pi into minus cos omega t, the limit 0 to pi. Substituting the upper and lower limit, we get minus Im by pi into cos pi minus cos 0. Substituting cos pi and cos 0 value, we get minus Im by pi into minus 1 minus 1. So cos pi value is minus 1, cos 0 value is 1. Simplifying this, we get IDC equal to 2 Im by pi. Similarly, VDC equal to 2 Vm by pi. Now, let us see another performance factor of full wave rectifier, RMS value. RMS value, IRMS equal to square root of 1 divided by pi, integral 0 to pi, Im sin omega t, the whole square into d of omega t. Now, substituting IL value, we get square root of 1 divided by pi, integral 0 to pi, Im sin square omega t into d of omega t. Im is constant. Taking outside the integral, we get Im square divided by pi, integral 0 to pi, Im sin square, sin square omega t into d of omega t. Now, substituting sin square omega t equal to 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2, we get IRMS equal to square root of Im square divided by pi integral 0 to pi 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2 into d of omega t. Now, integrating 1 minus cos 2 of omega t divided by 2, we get square root of Im square divided by pi into omega t divided by 2 minus sine 2 omega t divided by omega 2, the limit 0 to pi. Integrating cos 2 omega t equal to sine 2 omega t divided by 2. So, IRMS equal to square root of Im square divided by pi into omega t divided by 2 minus sine 2 omega t divided by 4. So, simplifying this equation and substituting the limit, we get IRMS equal to Im by root 2. Similarly, VRMS equal to Vm by root 2. Now, let us see the next performance parameter, ripple factor. Ripple factor is defined as the ratio of RMS value of AC voltage to average value or DC value of output. So, ripple factor gamma equal to square root of IRMS divided by IDC the whole square minus 1. Now, substituting IRMS and IDC value, we get square root of Im divided by root 2 whole divided by 2 Im divided by pi the whole square minus 1. IRMS value equal to Im by root 2. IDC value equal to 2 Im by pi. Simplifying this, we get 0.482. Percentage, this is the ripple factor of full wave rectifier. Percentage ripple factor is 48.2%. Peak inverse value of full wave rectifier is 2 Vm because the positive off cycle diode D1 is conducted, negative off cycle diode D2 is conducted. So, total peak inverse voltage is Vm plus Vm is equal to 2 Vm. Peak inverse voltage means maximum withstanding reverse voltage of the diode. In full wave rectifier, PIV equal to 2 Vm. Now let us see the next performance parameter, efficiency. Efficiency of the full wave rectifier is defined as the ratio of output power to input power. Here output power is DC power, input power is AC power. Output power is denoted PDC and input power is denoted PAC. So, efficiency equal to PDC divided by PAC. PDC equal to IDC squared into RL. PAC equal to IRMS squared into RL plus RF plus RS. Here, RS equal to transformer secondary resistance. RF equal to diode forward resistance. RL is load resistance. Now, substituting IDC and IRMS value, we get 2 Im by pi divided by Im by root 2 the whole squared into RL divided by RL plus RF plus RS. Now, simplifying this equation, we get 8 divided by pi squared into RL divided by RL plus RS plus RF. Comparing RL value, RS and RF value is very, very low. So, neglecting this, we get 8 divided by pi squared into RL by RL. Cancelling RL value, we get efficiency equal to 8 by pi squared. Converting this into numerical value, we get eta equal to 0.812. Percentage of efficiency equal to 81.2%. This is a higher value compared to half wave rectifier. Now let us see the another one performance parameter in full wave rectifier is TUF. I already told TUF means how much amount of transformer is utilized in this circuit. In standard tapped full wave rectifier, TUF is found by considering primary and secondary VA rating separately. So, I'm taking average value for final TUF. TUF of secondary is calculated. TUF of secondary is equal to PDC divided by PAC rated. PDC equal to IDC squared into RL. PAC rated equal to VAC rated into IAC rated. VAC rated means VRMS. IAC rated means IRMS. Substituting PIDC and VRMS IRMS value, we get 2 Im by pi the whole square into RL divided by Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. So simplifying this, we get TUF equal to 8 divided by pi square, that's equal to 0.811, that's equal to 81.1%. So TUF of secondary equal to 81.1%, but TUF of primary equal to 2 into half wave rectifier, TUF of half wave rectifier, that is the primary input both the primary supplies input for both the half cycle of input. So TUF of primary equal to 2 into TUF of half wave rectifier, that's equal to 2 into 0.288, that's equal to 0.572. So total TUF of standard topped transformer equal to TUF of primary plus TUF of secondary. Substituting TUF of primary and secondary value, we get TUF equal to 0.572 plus 0.811 divided by 2. That's equal to TUF equal to 0.692. Percentage of TUF equal to 69.3%. So in full wave rectifier, we are using 69.3% of transformer. This is high value compared to half wave rectifier. Now let us see the full wave bridge rectifier. Full wave bridge rectifier eliminate the disadvantage of full wave standard topped rectifier. Full wave standard topped rectifier has only one disadvantage. It requires standard tap transformer, but in full wave bridge rectifier, there is no need of standard tapped transformer. So in full wave bridge rectifier consists one transformer. It consists four diodes. The diodes are arranged in bridge form. And also it consists one load. The input is applied to primary of the transformer. The output of the secondary of the transformer is applied to rectifier circuit. The rectifier circuit consists diode and load. Then here we are using four diodes. The diodes arranged in bridge manner. During the positive off cycle of the applied AC input signal, the secondary transformer terminal, upper terminal is positive and lower terminal is negative. Under this condition, diode D1 and diode D3 is forward bias, D2 and D4 is reverse bias. So current flows through the device or load from upper terminal of the transformer to D1 load and D3 to lower terminal of the secondary transformer. So output appear across the load. During the negative off cycle of the applied AC input signal, the secondary transformer upper terminal is negative, lower terminal is positive. Now diode D2 and D4 is forward bias and D1 and D3 is reverse bias. So diode D2 and D4 is conductor. So current flows through from lower terminal of the transformer to D4 load, D2 and upper terminal of the secondary transformer. So current flows through the load, output appear across the load. So both the up cycle, we get the output. Figure shows the input and output waveform of full wave bridge rectifier. First, the waveform is in applied input waveform. The second waveform is bridge full wave rectifier output waveform. During positive off cycle, diode D1 and D3 is forward bias. It conducts, so output appear across the load. During negative off cycle, diode D4 and D2 is forward bias. It conducts, so output appear across the load. Here, we are not using standard topped transformer. So, maximum secondary voltage is appear across the output. But in standard topped full wave rectifier, half of the secondary voltage is appeared across the output. But here, total secondary voltages appear across the output. For an example, in full wave bridge rectifier, Vm is output voltage, But in center tapped full wave rectifier, Vm by 2 is output voltage. Now let us see the performance analysis of full wave bridge rectifier. Full wave bridge rectifier performance analysis is same to the full wave center tapped rectifier for average value, RMS value, ripple factor, efficiency. But it is differ from PIV and TVF. In full wave bridge rectifier, the PIV value is only 1 Vm. So because here we are not using standard adapter transformer, so maximum peak inverse in full wave bridge rectifier is 1 Vm. That's equal to Vm. The second TUF. TUF is different from standard tapped full wave rectifier to bridge full wave rectifier, because here we are not using standard tapped transformer. So TUF is defined as the ratio of DC output power to AC power rating of transformer secondary winding. So TUF equal to PDC divided by PAC rated. PDC equal to IDC squared into RL, but PAC rated equal to VAC rated into IAC rated. VAC rated means Vm by root 2. IAC rated means Im by root 2. Substituting IDC, IDC, IRMS, VRMS value, we get TUF equal to 2 Im by pi the whole squared into RL divided by Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. Simplifying this equation, we get 2 Vm by pi squared into RL divided by Vm by root 2 into Vm by root 2 into RL. Here, Im equal to Vm by RL. Instead of Im, we substituting Vm by RL. So TUF equal to 2 Vm by pi the whole square divided by RL into Vm by root 2 into Vm by root 2 into RL, cancelling RL term. On simplifying this, we get TUF equal to 0.812. Percentage of TUF equal to 81.2%. This is very high value compared to half wave rectifier and standard tap full wave rectifier. So in this bridge full wave rectifier, we are using 81% of transformer. Now let us see the comparison of half wave and full wave standard tap bridge full wave rectifier. In half-wave rectifier, we are using only one diode, but in center-tapped full-wave rectifier, we are using two diodes, but in bridge full-wave rectifier, we are using four diodes. Transformer necessary. In half-wave rectifier, there is no need of center-tapped transformer, but in center-tapped full-wave bridge rectifier, need of full-wave center-tapped bridge transformer. In bridge full wave rectifier, there is no need of standard tapped transformer. Maximum efficiency level of half wave rectifier is 40.6%. Standard tapped full wave rectifier is 81.2%. Bridge full wave rectifier is 81.2%. Ripple factor of half wave rectifier is 1.21. In percentage, 121%. Standard tapped full wave rectifier is 48%. Bridge full wave rectifier is 48%. Output frequency of half wave rectifier is single VFN. Standard tapped and bridge full wave rectifier is two times of input frequency. Peak inverse voltage of half wave rectifier is Vm. Standard tapped full wave rectifier is 2 Vm. Bridge full wave rectifier is Vm. TUF of half wave rectifier is 28.7%. Standard tapped full wave rectifier is 69.2%. Bridge full wave rectifier is 81%. Now let us conclude the today's session. Today we are discuss what is PN junction diode and structure of PN junction diode, operation of PN junction diode, and VI characteristics of PN junction diode. Then next topic, rectifier. Rectifier, in this rectifier we are discuss about what is rectifier and types of rectifier and their performance analysis of rectifier. Thank you.